Yeah.
Because the thing gets yelling.
These are beautiful.
Yeah.
family? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm bringing in the light, it's actually pen number 322.
What's the first one? Because it's not up to the grain.
322.
Okay, I have one announcement to be made. Your last song, The Lord Is Risen Today, is not on page 158, it's on page 302. That's the last song. Please stand as you will be able to stand. I'm okay this morning. Let's join in with our call to worship. Out of the darkness of grief and despair comes a message of hope. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
We run to the tomb to see for ourselves, and it is true. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
We hear a voice call our name, and we know our risen Lord is with us now in our homes.
Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Let us join together in our opening prayer. O God,
bless us this morning with resurrection rampage, a rampage that summons us to shout out yes to deserve the true creation and be in our midst. May we experience the earthquakes of new life in our lives and in our congregation. The sun is up, and we are up in the sun. Despite all those things that seek to pull us down to despair, we are your future people. Amen.
Let us join together in the Apostles' Creed. I believe
in God, the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. Third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and stood at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. Our prayer song is Spirit of the Living God, which can be found in your hymnal on page 393.
You look like you're so happy for that prayer request. Here. did it a long time before, without bullets, so, so good. Yes.
I got my biopsy done, so we're just waiting to, for the results.
Because you already have proof of this.
It is my.
And Jackie's back also, she's been with us for a while.
So like, what is that old show, that way? Yes, sir.
I would like, so like hers, for my stepdaughter and Matt, they did a biopsy this week and we're waiting for the results. I also need hers for, my brother-in-law Benny. He had pneumonia, coughed so hard he coughed a hole in his lung and lung glass, and now they're having trouble pumping the hole. So, we need to.
Wayne, did you have one?
Another person was going through, when we were talking about these words, they were involved in Carl's and a month ago, his heart test, really, within the last week. And.
Here's the accident.
And I used to work part-time at Stratton Hills, and all customers for a little bit. She thought about my husband as a prostate cancer, of course, but he's not coming.
I also like words for a young lady that I raised with a prayer a couple months ago, who I said had stroke. We want to get her day 40. I found out just a little while ago that she finally came home, but she's still in need of a lot of prayer because she cannot walk. Her name is Diana.
Diana? Anyone else? Well, hi.
Stars, Annette, I've got a son, a daughter-in-law.
Annette and my husband's brother, my brother-in-law Benny.
Okay.
Tip brother.
Oh, and Annette's got a daughter. Okay, thank you.
Well, it sounds funny, but Jen and I went to church last night, and it was probably first time in how long? In a year, well, yeah. First time in a year that we were able to go and not have any responsibilities whatsoever. And just to worship and to enjoy the atmosphere, and as Jen said, she actually got to sit with me. Whether I'm here or there, we don't necessarily sit together during service. So that was a joy to be able to go and just be part of the service. Yes.
A quick thing was, I went to the interdenominational school party service,
yes.
And they collected $1,000 for the food pantry.
Great. Do they always get to the food pantry?
Yes, usually.
Well, let us pray. Oh, Lord, we come to you ready for the tomb to be empty. We're so grateful for this day to where we know that Jesus defeated death and the promises that were made to us in our faith. We just don't know how to express ourselves sometimes when it comes to how much you love us. But if we really just think about it, the empty tomb really says it all. The fact that Jesus died, was risen, and will come again. We thank you with all our hearts. help us to remember that each day. And we ask you to be with George as he has his procedure tomorrow. Be with Ellen's sister-in-law as she continues to be cancer-free, allow that to be a permanent thing. Be with her through the rest of the healing process. Be with Kay as she awaits the news from her biopsy. We thank you, Lord, that we are able to have Chris with us this morning. And we ask you to be with Annette and watch over her. And also be with Benny, who's having serious lung issues. Be with Wayne's co-workers and the family of the co-worker as his wife passed away. And also be with the old customer that has cancer. Allow them to be able to be treated in the best way possible. Allow them to have the right doctors and find the best treatment for them. We ask you to be with Diane, who had a stroke, but as she is home, we thank you for that. Allow her to continue to get better and recover. Lord, we know that you have the most amazing healing power. We just ask you to be with her. And we thank you for the $1,000 that were raised. Lord, we ask you to let that go towards things that people need. Allow it to help many, many families and multiply. And let them be able to understand where it came from and to know your love through us. Lord, we thank you so much for the many blessings you give us, the grace that you give us each second of the day. And most of all, we thank you for today and your Son, Jesus. Let us join together in the prayer that he taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Join with us in singing hymn 310. Thank you.
Our scripture lesson today is from the first book of Corinthians, the 15th chapter, verses 1 through 11. Now I would remind you of good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I termed, had received that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me, for I am the least of the apostles, and fit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am where I am, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thank you, God.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Do we know that one? He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we just ask you to continue to be with us through the rest of the service, with the music that we hear, the scriptures. Let your spirit work the way that we know it. Be with us here in this place. Let my words be pleasing to you. In Jesus' name. Amen. So last night when we went to the church, the sermon was kind of he started in one place and he ended in another, which is kind of my favorite way of hearing a sermon. Because it catches you off guard. It's like, oh, that's where he's going. So I had to laugh because as he got to the end, I'm listening and I thought, well, if anybody was with me last night and then hear me preach this morning, they're going to think that I'm stealing his sermon. But he talked about how Easter should be every day for us. Jesus didn't just rise from the dead today. We should be grateful for that tomorrow and next Sunday. So he went on to talk about, just being able to be grateful for Christ and what he did every day of the year. And if you heard in 1 Corinthians about how about believing in vain. I think this is what they're talking about. Because if we come and we celebrate Easter, but we don't live it, I don't think we get it. So that's kind of where we're going today. So I want to, a pastor and agnostic walk into a coffee bar. Sound like a joke, right? One of my friends that I work with, he has admittedly went from being an atheist to an agnostic. He'll ask me questions and we'll talk, and there's times where I'll ask him a question. And we just bounce the ideas and talk back and forth. But he, through our little work messaging thing, he goes, Bill, I got a story I want to share with you, but it's too much to type. So can we do coffee sometime? And, morning, welcome. And we started to talk about an experience that his half-brother had. And his half-brother, it was a really long story, I'll shorten it up for you. His aortic in his chest popped. And he was giving a speech, and he said, I don't feel good, I'm gonna go back to the hotel and I'm gonna rest. And they said, well, it's too late, we already called an ambulance. So the ambulance came and they found out what happened to him. They said that 1% of the people that had that happen survived. And the surgery he was about to have to repair it, only 5% survived. So he went, had the surgery, and he said he coded during the surgery, and he said that when he felt himself going, he said there was no bright light, but when he got to where he was going, he had an overwhelming peace and love that he couldn't explain. And he said, for a split second, I knew everything. And he looked, I'm not talking about everything that was, you know, remembered everything that happened in my life. I knew everything. I had the knowledge of everything. And he said that as he was experiencing this, he saw three figures, and the middle one said, you're not done yet, you're going back. And right away I said, three. Sounds like the Trinity to me, and my friend said, yep, absolutely, that's the first thing that came to mind. So his half-brother, he comes back to life and shares a story with my friend, his half-brother. Now, my friend was telling me, he goes, you know, I mess around a lot on YouTube, and I scroll through the videos, and I look, and he goes, but I hardly ever stop on the faith ones. He goes, whatever reason, I stopped and I hit play and I listened to this guy's story. And he goes, you know, it was the same story that my half-brothers told me. This is why we can't take Easter for granted. Because God works. God works in so many different ways. So we're going to go to the scripture, but I want to explain a little bit about the picture on the altar here. You see, the great thing about our experience with God is the fact that when we accept Him, and even after that, when we don't have the greatest day and we have our setbacks, we feel like we get dirty and unworthy. But God is like a pitcher of water. See, your hands get dirty. Your life gets dirty. And you can go to that water and you can rinse them off. And you can come out with a clean heart and a clean soul. And the water keeps all the dirt. That is what Christ does for us. He says, let me take the burden off you. You just live the best life you can. So when you have those moments of feeling unworthy, unloved, you made a mistake, you accosted somebody in traffic, you might not have had the most pleasant attitude to somebody in the grocery store, and you go, I really, really feel bad about that because that's not who I am. And you go and you ask for forgiveness. And God reminds us constantly that you are worthy of my love. So we don't want to live and celebrate Easter in vain. We want to have it mean something. The two scriptures I want to share are from the lectionaries, and it's not all of them. But I wanted to share a little bit about what they said. So this is from John chapter 20. Early in the morning of the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw the stone had been taken away from the tomb. She ran to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put it." Peter and the other disciple left to go to the tomb. They were running together, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter, and was the first to arrive at the tomb. Bending down to take a look, he saw the linen clothes lying there, but he didn't go in. Following him, Simon Peter entered the tomb and saw the linen clothes lying there. So there's two things I want us to think about with this scripture. I had somebody tell me this a long time ago, and it made sense, so I want to share it with you. We have a lot of people that have issues, maybe not here, but I hear a lot about it at school, at course of study. There's still a lot of churches out there that have issues with female pastors. The first two people that found the empty tomb were women. And if it wasn't for those two women going to tell the disciples that Jesus is risen, where would we be? The second thing I want us to think about is all through the scripture I just read, they didn't walk. They didn't briskly walk. They didn't skip. They ran to tell the story. They didn't stay put and expect people to come and say, "Hey, what are you doing here?" See, look, the tomb's open. They ran to tell the story. And that's what we forget sometimes as a church. We forget that as much as we want it to be about us, it's not. That we run and we tell people the story about my hands, my soul, my heart was dirty at one time. And Christ said, "Let me take that from you." You have to run and tell that story, right? The second one is from Acts. A lot of people, sometimes churches get a little, who is allowed? And who we want here and who we don't want here. In Acts 10, it tells us, Peter said, "I really am learning that God doesn't show partiality to one group of people over the other. Rather, in every nation, whoever worships him and does what is right is acceptable to him. This is the message of peace he sent to the Israelites by proclaiming the good news through Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all." You have an AA group that meets here twice a week, and I know of many other churches that do that as well. We wanted to have one. This was probably about 12 years ago, maybe longer. We wanted to have one. And does anybody know the old building that Griffith was in, the big, okay? Keep that in mind. We wanted to have an AA meeting, the head person and the person who was wanting from the church to be part of it came in and talked to our trustees. And I was part of the trustees, and we were sitting there, and the day that they meet on, was a day that I think the kids' club was on. So the majority, which is why it didn't happen, the majority of the trustees said, we don't want to have those people around the kids. We think that that could open us up to problems. And me and some other people that were before the idea was, we didn't understand the concern, because if you know that building, there's at least 7 entrances. We could have made it work. But is it because we didn't want to make it work? God's love is for everyone. That's what Acts tells us. So when we celebrate Easter, we have to realize that His love is here for everyone, number one. And number two, we have to treat each day like an Easter and be joyful in His resurrection. And to understand that because it happened once isn't the point. The point is what came from it happening once. And that was reconciling us, taking our sins off of us, so we could be one with God. That is what Easter is all about. So the sermon title is called What's Next? I think that we need to seriously think about what's next. Because the joy that we feel today, because it's Easter and we know that Jesus defeated death, has to be a feeling that we take into tomorrow and we share. That's what an Easter celebration should be about. Now, as we do communion, I want us to remember everything we went through this week, from Monday, Thursday, to Good Friday, to this morning. And understand that that was done for the world. That was done for everyone. Let us not take Easter and make it a vain holiday, an empty holiday. Let us be able to take it and keep it in our hearts for the whole year. If you would open up your hymnals to page 9. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
It is right to give our thanks and praise. I'm sorry, let us give thanks to the Lord. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And so with your people on earth and all the company in heaven, we praise your name and join our unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach the good news to the poor, proclaim release to the captives, and recovering of sight. set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick, fed the hungry, and ate with sinners. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always, in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and the blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, with the confidence of children, let us pray together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, and as we forgive those who sin against us, save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. And thine is the kingdom, power, and the power of the world, forever and ever.
Because there is one loaf, we who are many are one body, for all partake of the one loaf. The bread which we break is a sharing of the body of Christ. The cup over which we give thanks is a sharing blood of Christ. go into the world in the strength of your spirit to give ourselves for others in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. You would please stand as the offerings was brought forward. God's steadfast love endures forever. He is our strength, our might, and our salvation. Because of this love, we shall not die. This is God's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. The final hymn for today is 302. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. This hymn 302.
Thank you.
take a look at that picture on the altar by the cross. Let God take your dirty stuff. Let Him clear your heart and your mind, and trust in Him that He has enough strength to take on all our bad stuff. And help us to be able to go on tomorrow rejoicing in that, and on Tuesday rejoicing in that, and Wednesday rejoicing in that. Because Easter doesn't end today. Our Savior